Friends, next we'll start with the new topic, capacitance of two-wire line. Okay, so let us consider the two-wire line which forms a two parallel plate capacitors. So the radius of the cylinder is always very small. Hence, let us consider these two lines, this line and this line, are located at a distance, say this is your positive A and this is your negative A. So the coordinates at this point will be minus A, 0, 0, because it x, y, z. This is negative z, so this is having only a negative value of x. And here it is a positive value of x, so it is having a coordinate of A, 0, 0. So this line, okay, so the line charge density will be a positive rho L Coulomb per meter. Whereas for this row, this line, the line charge density will be minus rho L Coulomb per meter. Okay. So, and already in the previous lectures and videos, like, we have seen that the voltage difference, okay, which has for an infinite value of line, is usually given by V is equal to rho L upon 2 pi epsilon logarithmic of, okay, R naught divided by R. This is epsilon naught divided by, you'll be getting. So since we are considering with this R naught is nothing but this reference point, which is at the equal distance from your line R2 and from your line R1. Okay, so let us obtain now the potential separately for this line 1 and line 2. Okay, so let us obtain a potential at point P. This is a point where, like, you have to desire your voltage difference. Okay, so I'll be considering this point alone. So now, with the using a principle of superposition theorem, and applying the above V, I'll just have V is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon log national logarithmic of R naught by R1 for your line 1, and second will be your rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon natural logarithmic of R naught by R2. Okay, and now taking the common term, you just have rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon logarithmic of R naught R2 minus R naught into R1. Okay, taking in the vice versa directions, like, you just have this value with you. Okay, so now it is like, since we have assumed the zero reference point, okay, this is your reference point R naught, and it is at the equidistance from your R1 and R2. And with the formula of geometry arrangement, I can just write my R1 is equal to, so what are the points I have? Minus A, 0, 0. Another one is A, 0, 0. Okay. So other point is X, Y and 0. So X, Y, 0 with respect to this point and X, Y, 0 with respect to this point. So R1. So this is my R1. So X, Y, 0 coordinate with A, 0, 0 coordinate I have to write. So I'll be just getting x minus a, okay, so this x minus a the whole squared plus y squared, y minus 0 and z you don't have. So this is your R1. Similarly for your R2, I'll just have x plus a the whole squared plus y squared. Okay, so now substituting these two value in this above expression, say a, so I'll be just having V is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon natural logarithmic of, okay, R naught R2, R naught R1. So I'll just have R naught, alright, this gets cancelled, and I just have R2 and R1 alone. So R2 value is again x plus a the whole squared plus y squared divided by x minus a the whole squared plus y squared, and they both are under root. Okay, so now what will I have? This 1 by 2 gets into your denominator term. So I'll just have rho l divided by 4 pi epsilon natural logarithmic of this corresponding value. Okay. Clear till this? Okay. So now, next what we are going to do, we are going to consider that the surface is at the equipotential distance. So we'll be having this V is equal to V1 because of your equipotential property. And the location of this can be found by using a constant value of C1. Okay. So now, from this expression, okay, so this basic expression, like what can I do is, I can just consider this value to be a constant and natural logarithmic of some this value to be a potential value, okay. So I'll be just getting C1 is equal to e power 4 pi epsilon V1 divided by rho L, okay, this value, see, 4 pi epsilon into V1. This is my V1. V I have substituted as V1. So getting cross multiplied and taking a anti-log, I'll be having an exponential value. And this C is not a capacitance. This is a constant. Don't get confused. Okay. This is a constant and not a capacitance. So now with this value, I can just have my C1. Therefore, this is my constant value. And so I will just have my C1, okay, this C1 expression to be this expression now, okay, which is x plus a the whole squared plus y squared divided by x minus a the whole squared plus y squared. I am repeating what we are doing it. So I am just taking this B1 equal to this expression, okay, so this expression into this value. So now taking this to be a constant C1, what I'm going to do, C1 is nothing but my rho L divided by 4 pi epsilon into natural logarithmic. To cancel this logarithmic value, what I'm going to do, I'll be having this C1, some constant value, is equal to 4 pi, getting cross multiplied, 4 pi epsilon divided by my rho L, okay, into, for this I'll be having e to the power. So now I have got a constant and this is my voltage V. Okay. So now this C1 I have just have. So C1 is equal to x plus this value. Okay. So now what I'm going to do next, I'm just going to cross multiply this value to have x squared minus 2ax plus a squared plus y squared into my C1 is equal to x squared plus 2ax plus a squared plus my y squared term. Okay. Now taking all the C1 term common, I'll just have x squared into C1 minus 1. So this value I'm taking it to the other side. So I'll have C1 minus 1 minus 2ax into C1 plus 1. That is, I'm just segregating all the terms together, okay, and a squared will be C1 minus 1 plus y squared into C1 minus 1 is equal to 0, okay. So now what I'm going to do, next step, I'll be dividing the entire equation by C1 minus 1, okay. So now what I'll have after dividing, I'll just arrive at this expression, x squared minus 2ax C1 plus 1 divided by C1 minus 1 into a squared plus y squared equal to 0. Okay. So after dividing this entire expression by this, I'll be having this simple expression. Okay. So now to make this to a complete square equation, I'll be interchanging the terms and I'll be arranging this as, okay, So I'll be doing it as x minus a into c1 plus 1 divided by c1 minus 1 the whole squared plus y squared is equal to a squared c1 plus 1 by c1 minus 1 minus a squared. Okay, so now like what we are doing, basically from the previous expression you have to take all the LCM common out, then take a values, and then on simplification like you'll be getting this value. Okay, so which I can write it as x minus a into c1 plus 1 divided by c1 minus 1 the whole squared plus y squared is equal to 2a root c1 by c1 minus 1. Okay, so this term alone, I'll just explain you how you have got this term. Okay, so first from this above expression you have a squared. Okay, then you have to take an LCM which is c1 minus 1 the whole squared, and you have to expand the above expression and take a common LCM out, and you'll be getting out this term. Okay, so now this is nothing but your equation of your circle, which is of the common form x minus h the whole squared plus y minus k the whole squared, that is equal to r squared. Okay, so with this expression, like what we are going to just assume it is, you'll be having b equal to, okay, this expression I'll be taking it as b, radius is my b. So b is equal to 2a root of c1 upon c1 minus 1, and it has a center at h of h comma 0. Okay, and my h is equal to this term c1 plus 1 divided by c1 minus 1. Okay, so what is the next step, like what we are going to consider is, we have to assume a potential is at 0 and the plane is located at x equal to 0. Okay, and a radius is equal to b, and at the axis of x equal to h, this is nothing but your axis. Okay, so from this expression of your b and h, I have to find what is my value of a and c. Okay, so from this expression what I have told you, we have to express in terms of your a and c. Okay, so considering this expression, now I'll be substituting this as my h, and this already I have taken it out as h, so I'll be just having a. Okay, so which is h minus a the whole squared, so I'll be getting h square minus a squared, that is equal to my b squared. So from that expression I can just write h squared minus b squared is equal to a squared, therefore my a is equal to root of h squared minus b squared, and I'll be getting on solvation for c1 as h plus root of h squared minus b squared divided by b. Okay, so these two basic expression like we have to keep remembering. And also we have seen from the previous expression that what I have got value of c, that is constant, is equal to e power 4 pi, okay, epsilon v naught by rho l. So from this rho l I can write it as, so this will be a logarithmic of c1 divided by, okay, so I'll just have rho l is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon into v naught divided by my natural logarithmic of my c1. Okay, so this is one expression, and also I know that the total charge q is equal to my rho l into l. So now considering this all expression, and also I know the value of my capacitance c is equal to q divided by v. Okay, and V is with respect to my initial potential, V naught. So I'll be having Q is rho L into L divided by V naught. So where this V naught have just arrived at, okay, so this will be rho L is nothing but my 4 pi epsilon into V naught divided by natural logarithmic of C1 into L divided by V naught. This gets cancelled out, okay, and I have what is the value of my C1 as well. So substituting that value, 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon into L divided by logarithmic of root of C1, okay, and this L is because of my two lines and equipotential lines as well. So since we have considered at the midpoint exactly that R0, the value of L will be L divided by 2. So this gets cancelled out and I'll have 2 pi epsilon into L divided by logarithmic of my C1. And C1, I'm well aware, what is C1? Is nothing but my constant, what I have arrived at. So logarithmic of my h plus root of h squared plus b squared divided by b. Okay, so now this very well recalls me an expression of logarithmic of x plus root of x squared minus 1, which is nothing but cos h inverse of x. Okay, so substituting that in this value, I'll be arriving C is equal to 2 pi epsilon L divided by cos H inverse of H by B. Okay, so this is a basic expression for your capacitance, and provided one conditions I have. What is that condition? I should have my B always lesser than my H. Okay, so and also this equation of B should be lesser than X H because it is the distance that is twice 2H is half of my capacitance what I have considered. The total height should be half of your total length I am going to consider. Okay, so this expression, so considering that, I'll be just dividing it by 2. Okay, I again repeat, the capacitance for your two circular conductors, they are separated by a distance of 2H, which is half the capacitance. Okay, so this capacitance equation should be C by 2. So finally, I'll be arriving at the expression of pi epsilon L divided by cos H inverse of H by B. Okay, so this is your total expression what we arrive for a capacitance of your two wire line. Okay, thank you.